everyone, welcome back to the chemistry webinar session. We have with us Mrs. Sridevi Polu, principal, Telangana Model School, Pudur. Good morning, madam.
Good morning, madam.
Madam is once again with us to explain about the properties of carbonyl compounds, that is aldehydes and ketones. Welcome, madam. The session is all yours.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Good morning, children. Once again, a happy welcome for the chemistry webinar. Myself, Mrs. Sridevi Polu, is here to teach you the chemical properties of carbonyl compounds. See, what are carbonyl compounds? Aldehydes and ketones are combinedly known as carbonyl compounds. Why they are called as carbonyl compounds? Because they contain the carbonyl group. See here. So this is the carbonyl group. See, double bond O group is called as a carbonyl group. As both the aldehydes and ketones contain this group in common, they are called as carbonyl compounds. And in my previous sessions, I have taught you the preparation methods of both aldehydes and ketones, right? And yesterday I have started the chemical properties of aldehydes. And before going to the chemical properties of these aldehydes and ketones, let me briefly explain you what we have learned yesterday. See, coming to the chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones, the carbonyl group, double bond O group, it is a highly polar one. Why it is a highly polar one? Because carbon belongs to the fourth group and oxygen belongs to the sixth group. There is large electronegative difference between carbon and oxygen. So there will be shift of the pi electrons towards the oxygen atom. And hence, this carbon develops a partial positive charge and oxygen a partial negative charge. Okay, so and hence we consider this as a highly polar one. And then these two atoms, that is the carbon and oxygen, becomes the active centers. Means the reagent can attack both the centers, either the carbon or the oxygen. Okay, and then the carbon is attacked by the electron rich nucleophiles. What are nucleophiles? Nucleus loving species, electron rich species are called as nucleophiles. And hence, if the reagent attacks the carbon atom, then the reactions are nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay. So nucleophilic addition reactions. And then yesterday I have explained you regarding the nucleophilic addition mechanism also. Isn't it, children? So this is the nucleophilic, right? So nucleophilic addition mechanism. So Z minus is the nucleophile. It is an electron rich species, nucleus loving species, which is attacking the carbon atom, which is electron deficient. So hence, it is a nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay. And now, let us move to the properties, what we have learned yesterday. So, I will explain all these properties once again to you, right? And then we will move to the today's session. So, the first reaction is addition of sodium bisulfite. See, this is sodium bisulfite. And I have shown you which is the nucleophile here and the electrophilic part here. So SO3 minus Na is the nucleophile, which is attacking the carbon atom. See here. And what is the product? Acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite, right? Then the next one is addition of HCN, hydrogen cyanide. In hydrogen cyanide, cyanide is the nucleophilic part and H plus is the electrophilic part. So the cyanide will be attacking the carbon atom, and then the compound obtained is acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. And then here, I mentioned you that this reaction is taking place in the presence of a base. Okay, so then we have moved to the remaining properties. So the next one is addition of Grignard's reagent, right? RMGX is the Grignard's reagent, alkyl magnesium halides are called as Grignard's reagents. Acetaldehyde reacts with methyl magnesium bromide. What is it? Methyl magnesium bromide. So this is R. just now I told you RMGX. X may be a halide. X is a halide. It may be either fluorine, chlorine, bromine, or iodine. Right? So alkyl magnesium halides are called as Grignard's reagent. I'll write here once again. So for your easy understanding. So alkyl magnesium halides are called as Grignard's reagent. Right? Grignard's reagent. So once again, I'm telling you that Grignard's reagent are having lot of industrial applications. And almost all the organic compounds can be prepared from this Grignard's reagent. That's why they are having lot of synthetic applications. Okay, so then acetaldehyde is treated with methyl magnesium bromide. And on further hydrolysis gives a secondary alcohol. What is it? Secondary alcohol. And then what happens when this formaldehyde reacts with methyl magnesium bromide, right? So when formaldehyde reacts with methyl magnesium bromide, that is our Grignard's reagent, RMGBr. Okay, so then we get a primary alcohol. Here, what you have to understand, children, you have to understand that formaldehyde, when treated with Grignard's reagent, gives primary alcohol. Then acetaldehyde treated with Grignard's reagent gives secondary alcohol. Okay, so I hope you got the point here. Okay, so now just imagine what happens when acetone reacts with the Grignard's reagent. Right, now let us see this property. The next one, what we have learned in our yesterday's session, is addition of alcohols. Right, alcohols, addition of alcohols. So let us see this once again. Okay, so addition of alcohols, ROH, alkyl hydroxy compounds are called as alcohols. And see here, we have seen two cases, isn't it? See, one is catalyzed by acid in 1:1 ratio, and the other one is catalyzed by acid in 1:2 ratio, right? Okay, so here, see this acetaldehyde, when treated with alcohol in 1:1 ratio, both of them are in 1:1 ratio. In the presence of dry HCl and dilute HCl, it gives an unstable hemiacetal. See, these reactions are very, very important for your objective, Nana. Okay, please remember this. So this is the most stable unstable hemiacetal. This is the unstable hemiacetal. Then see the second case, when it is catalyzed by an acid in 1:2 ratio. So here it is in 1 ratio and this is in 1:2 ratio. In the presence of dry HCl and dilute HCl, we get a stable compound, which is acetal. And here I have mentioned you that this is a gem dialkoxy alkane, gem dialkoxy, alkoxy group. Alkyl group clubbed with oxygen is called as alkoxy. And how many groups, such groups are here? Two groups. So it is dialkoxy. Gem means when both the groups are attached to the same carbon, then it is called as gem dialkoxy alkane. Okay, Nana? That. Okay, so I think after this, we have dealt yesterday, isn't it, children? Yes, of course. And let us move to the remaining chemical properties today, right? So just a recapitulation of what we have learned yesterday. So coming to the today's session, so we are continuing the chemical properties of aldehydes, children. So chemical properties of aldehydes. So in continuation of our yesterday's session, we are here learning the chemical properties of aldehydes. So the next one is addition of ammonia. What is it? Addition of ammonia. Okay, addition of ammonia. So I think we are dealing with the fifth property, addition of ammonia. So let us see the reaction. Acetaldehyde, CH3, CH double bond O, acetaldehyde, when treated with ammonia, what happens? Let us see here. So it is a reversible reaction and it takes place in the presence of an acid H+. Okay, so then what you'll get? You will get a compound, acetaldehyde ammonia. So what do you get? You will get acetaldehyde ammonia. Okay, this is our H and this is NH2. Then how do you get this? See here, this is NH2 and this is H. NH2 is added to the carbon and H is added to the oxygen. So what is the product? So this is acetaldehyde ammonia. Okay, what is it, Nana? Acetaldehyde ammonia, right? So now this acetaldehyde ammonia loses a water molecule. What is it? It loses a water molecule. So where does it lose a water molecule? OH from here and H from here, right? So you get the product like the CH3, CH. Okay, then single bond becomes double bond NH. Understood, Nana? So this is OH and this is H, which is eliminated in the form of H2O minus H2O. And see here, what is the name of the product which is obtained, right? It is having a double bond, isn't it? Yes. And it is having an amino group also. Then what we should call it? Imine. What is it? Imine. Acetaldehyde imine. Imine. Okay. So I will write here. Acetaldehyde imine. Okay, Nana. So acetaldehyde imine. Right. So this is addition of ammonia. Acetaldehyde reacts with ammonia and forms acetaldehyde ammonia. This is addition product, no doubt. And this will loses a water molecule. So from where this water molecule is eliminated, H from here and then, OH from here, H from here. So minus H2O. And what do you get? Acetaldehyde imine. So you will get acetaldehyde imine, right? So now here I want to mention you a few points, children. So the first one is, please make a note of this. So these two points are very, very important for your objective session. So the first one is when formaldehyde, okay? So what is formaldehyde? HCHO, right? So this is C, Nana. HCHO. Formaldehyde reacts with ammonia. So please remember, when formaldehyde reacts with ammonia, so it forms hexamethylene. Okay, so what does it form? It forms hexamethylene. Okay, so just a minute. Hexamethylene, right? I will write here itself. Tetramine, okay? Hexamethylene, tetramine. And what is its applications? It is important, children. So this is a hexamethylene, tetramine. So it is used as a urinary antiseptic, right? So urinary antiseptic, urinary antiseptic under the commercial name urotropin. So what is the name of this? Urotropin, right? Urotropin. So please remember, hexa means how many, Nana? 6. This is the methylene group, hexamethylene. So tetramine, 4, right? Okay, so then this is the first point which you have to remember, and then the second point I will tell you. when benzaldehyde, what is this? Benzaldehyde. When benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia, what does it form? It forms hydrobenzamide. To form hydrobenzamide. I hope everyone is copying all these reactions, Nana. So please try to understand, right? So we are sincerely putting all our efforts to reach you children during this pandemic, right? So almost all we have covered the entire syllabus except three topics in chemistry. We are just going to finish this organic chemistry, and after that transition elements, and then biomolecules and polymers also. Even though those topics are deleted, that is polymers, and in to some extent few topics in biomolecules were also deleted, but we want to teach you all those topics also. Why? Because you are going to write your competitive examinations, isn't it? So please keep this in your mind, Nana, and try to write down all the reactions, and try to compete with other children, right? So the addition of ammonia. So we have dealt with addition of ammonia. Here I have given you two important points to note down. So that is a formaldehyde. When treated with ammonia, what does it form? It forms an urinary antiseptic, which is sold under the name urotropine, right? So that is hexamethylene tetraamine. And then when benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia, right, it forms hydrobenzamide. What is that? Hydrobenzamide. Now, let us move to the remaining properties of, this aldehydes and ketones, children. So we are dealing with the chemical properties of aldehydes now. After finishing this, we will move to the remaining properties. And then now we are going to deal with the reactions involving elimination of water molecules, right? So reactions involving elimination of water molecules. Elimination of water molecules. See children, all the people, those who are very famous and who have achieved something in their lives, they used to tell us, isn't it? So practice makes a man perfect, and every day you should write at least one or two pages in your book. So please keep all these things in your mind and try to write down these reactions, Nana. So reactions involving elimination of water molecules. So we are going to see this reactions now. So reactions involving elimination of water molecules. So the first one is addition of hydroxyl amine. Addition of hydroxyl amine. Hydroxyl amine, right? So you know about hydroxyl group, isn't it? So what is that hydroxyl group? OH, amine NH2, isn't it? So now what is hydroxyl amine, right? NH2OH. Okay, NH2OH is the hydroxyl group. NH2OH, hydroxyl amine, very simple, hydroxyl amine. Now what happens when this hydroxyl amine is added to acetaldehyde? Let us see here. So acetaldehyde, CH3CH, okay, double bond O. Acetaldehyde reacts with hydroxyl amine. See, I will show you a simple method to write the products. Yes, right, this is NH2OH, don't get confused, this is NH2OH, but here I want to remove the water molecule, so that's why I'm writing like this. So see here how I will eliminate the water molecule. So you remove the water molecule like this, understood? So H2O is eliminated, isn't it? So I will minimize the pen. Yes, okay. So this is a H2O is eliminated like this. H2O is eliminated. Now, what is the product you will get? Yes, CH3. This is CH, simple, double bond and this is NaOH. Okay, Nana? Now, what is this? See, this is a hydroxyl amine, isn't it? So the compound obtained is called as acetaldehyde oxime. What is it? Oxime. This is the oxime. Okay, oxime, double bond and OH. And we call it as aldoxime. Why? Because it is an aldehyde, right? Which is giving this product. So aldoxime, acetaldehyde oxime, aldoxime. So acetaldehyde, right, reacts with hydroxylamine gives acetaldehyde oxime, that is aldoxime, right? So that is the first property for today's session. And then now let us see the next one, that is a addition of hydrazine. What is it? Hydrazine. What is hydrazine? Let us see. You know this. This is amino group, isn't it? Now another amino group. That's it. Hydrazine. Okay. Azo. When a bond is present in between two nitrogen atoms, it is called as azo. What is it? Azo. And as it contains the hydrogens, we call it as hydrazine. What is it, Nana? Hydrazine. Okay. So hope it is clear for you. Hydrazine. Right. So then now let us write the equation for this. Okay. Acetaldehyde reacts with hydrazine. So I'm showing you the simple technique how to get the product. This is NH2 hydrazine. What is eliminated? Yes, correct. H2O is eliminated, isn't it? H2O. Then what is the product? I hope many of you are able to tell the answer, right? I'm happy. So you will get, one minute, CH3, okay? This is a CH double bond N, NH2, double bond N, NH2, right? So this is hydrazine. This is acetaldehyde, and the product which is obtained is called as acetaldehyde hydrazone. What is it? Acetaldehyde hydrazone. Here also I have forgotten to show you the eliminated water molecule. And here also I will write that H2O is eliminated, isn't it? It's very simple. So what is the name of the product obtained here? Acetaldehyde hydrazone. Okay, Nana? Acetaldehyde hydrazone. Hydrazone, right? Please remember. Okay, so then now let us move to the next reaction. Okay, we'll go for a new board. So then now we have seen the reaction with the hydrazine, isn't it? Now the next one is addition of phenylhydrazine. What is it? Phenylhydrazine. See, all these are very simple. Just if you put them on a paper once, then you will say that, ma'am, it's very easy, ma'am. Phenylhydrazine. Okay, I'll show you how to write this. Nana, what is this group? Phenyl, isn't it? So this is phenyl group, C6H5-. What is hydrazine? Just now we have seen NH2. You remove a hydrogen and you substitute this phenyl group there. Simple. You will get phenylhydrazine. That's it. Finished. Phenylhydrazine. Isn't it? Yes. So it's very easy. So phenylhydrazine. Right? Phenylhydrazine. Now, what happens when it is treated with acetaldehyde? Let us see here. Okay, so we will go for another color. So CH3, CHO, again the same equation. how to eliminate the water molecule, right? So NH2, NH, okay, then C6H5. So we will write like this also, children. This is our phenyl group, isn't it? So for your convenience, I'm showing this is the structure also, NH, NH2, right? Always remember, nitrogen should be bonded with the three atoms, isn't it? So this is NH, NH2. 1 minute, I will write from this end. Then it will be easy for you. Like this, I will write NH, NH2. Finish. This is the phenyl group. This is the hydrazine. Phenyl hydrazine. Okay. So phenyl hydrazine. This is a structural formula. That is a molecular formula. That's it. Okay. What is eliminated? Again, water molecule is eliminated. Right? H2O is eliminated like this. Okay. Now, again, I can remove this if you don't want this. Okay. H2O is eliminated. Then what you get? You will get acetaldehyde phenylhydrazone. Acetaldehyde phenylhydrazone, like the CH3, CH double bond N, NH, C6H5. C6H5. Right? So what is this? Acetaldehyde phenyl, just we are adding the words and atoms, that's it. Acetaldehyde phenyl hydrazone. Organic chemistry is very easy, children, if you understand the concept. So the beauty of organic chemistry lies in the replacement of these atoms. Okay, so this is acetaldehyde phenyl hydrazone. What is eliminated? H2O is eliminated. Okay, so now let us move to the next one. The next reaction is addition of 2, 4, 6 trinitro. 1 minute. 2, 4 dinitro phenylhydrazine. Okay, phenylhydrazine. So this is the 2, 4 DNP test. DNP test. So this is called as a Bochs reagent. What is it? Bochs reagent. Both the aldehydes and ketones will give an orange precipitate with this Bochs reagent. That is a 2,4 DNP. 2,4 dinitro phenylhydrazine. Okay, Nana? So this test is used to identify the carbonyl compounds, because both of them will give this test. We can identify that carbonyl compounds are present in this reaction. Okay, so then now let us see this. Acetaldehyde. Okay, acetaldehyde reacts with CH3, CH double bond O. Acetaldehyde reacts with, this is our phenyl group, isn't it? Yes, phenyl group. 2, 4 nitro. This is nitro group 2. This is 4 nitro. Understood? 2, 4 dinitro, because nitro group is present twice, isn't it? At two positions, we call it as di. 2, 4 dinitro. This is a phenyl group and hydrazine. Yes, simple. NH, NH2. Understood, Nana? NH, NH2. Right? Again, I will write NH2. This is NH, NH2. So 2, 4 dinitro phenyl hydrazine. What is eliminated? Very simple. Again, our H2O is eliminated like this. H2O is eliminated. And what do you get? You will get CH3, CH double bond, N, NH. Okay. Then NO2, NO2. Okay, Nana? So what is this? 2,4 acetaldehyde, 2,4 dinitrophenylhydrazone, zone, right? Acetaldehyde, 2,4 DNPH. Acetaldehyde, 2,4 dinitrophenylhydrazone. Okay, that's it. Plus H2O is eliminated. Understood, Nana? I hope it is clear for you how the water molecule is eliminated. See, I have shown you in a very like a clear manner how the water molecules are eliminated. If you learn this concept, then everything will be very easy, children. Trust me. Okay. So then this is the Bochsch's test. Okay. So now let us move to the next one. So this is addition of semicarbazide. Okay. So what is it? Semicarbazide. So the next one, addition of semicarbazide. Semicarbazide. Now let us see how this reaction is taking place, children. Acetaldehyde reacts with semicarbazide. What is it? Semicarbazide. Okay, now what is the semicarbazide, children? NH2NH CONH2. What is it? NH2NH CONH2. So this is a semicarbazide. Semicarbazide. NH2NH CONH2. So again, what is eliminated? Yes, you are correct. Water molecule is eliminated, isn't it? How it is eliminated? So O from aldehyde and H2 from semicarbazide, like this, it is eliminated, and you will get the product acetaldehyde semicarbazone, CH double bond, NH CO NH2. So acetaldehyde semicarbazone plus water molecule as usual. Yes, done. Okay, so I hope it is clear for you, children. This is addition of semicarbazide. So acetaldehyde reacts with semicarbazide and forms acetaldehyde semicarbazone. Okay, semicarbazone, right? And then now let us see the most important reaction here. So this is addition of halogen, right? Halogen and KOH. What is KOH? Potassium hydroxide or sodium hypohalite, NaOX, right? NaOX. Now many of you might have identified this reaction. Yes, you are correct. It is the iodoform reaction. What is it? Iodoform reaction. So a very, very important reaction, please. Iodoform reaction. So don't think that ma'am, are the remaining reactions not important? It's not the question, but few reactions are very, very important, isn't it? We all know that VIPs, very, very important persons will be there, like that. This iodoform reaction is a very important reaction. So what is this iodoform reaction? Now let us see, children. So acetaldehyde, CH3CH double bond O, acetaldehyde reacts with iodine in the presence of potassium hydroxide and forms a compound CHI3. What is this CHI3? Tell me, what is CHCl3? Chloroform, isn't it? But and then what is CHI3? Iodoform. Very simple, right? CHI3 is iodoform. Iodoform and potassium formate, HCOK. Potassium formate and potassium iodide and water, right? So So this is the iodoform reaction. What is this? Iodoform reaction. So please remember like this. So this is the 34 and this is the 33. Like this, you just remember. Okay, so it's balanced now. Now let us write the names of the reactants and products. So this is our acetaldehyde, the reactant which is in the, which is present in all the reactions what we are learning right now. And this is our compound which is obtained, that is a product, iodoform. Okay, and now this is potassium, K is potassium, and this is the formate, potassium formate. Okay Nana, potassium formate, right? And potassium iodide and water. Now here I want to mention you an important point regarding this reaction, children. Please make a note of this. Okay, as per my knowledge Nana, so with all my references I'm giving you the most important points what you have to remember for your objective examinations also. So after that you should not feel that, oh ma'am didn't tell this. Okay, so for that sake I'm telling each and every important point. So the alcohols containing CH3, CH2, OH, right? Means, 1 minute. CH3, CH, OH group, and aldehydes, and ketones, aldehydes and ketones containing CH3, CO group. Please remember, CH3, CO group give yellow-colored crystals of iodoform. What does it mean? It means that the compounds other than these doesn't give this reaction. Understood? Give yellow-colored crystals of iodoform. Okay, Nana? So this is the iodoform reaction. Please remember. So the compounds which contain the CH3CO group in aldehydes and ketones, whereas in alcohols that is the CH3CH-OH group, gives this iodoform reaction. Now let us move to the another reaction of this. Okay, so let us move to the next reaction. So this is addition of chlorine, children. Addition of chlorine and HCl. And what we call this, tell me, is chlorination. If we add bromine, it is bromination. We are adding chlorine here, so this is chlorination. Addition of chlorine. Now let us see what we get as a product here. If acetaldehyde is added with chlorine, acetaldehyde CH3 CHO reacts with chlorine. Okay, so in the presence of sunlight here, okay, what happens is, so see here, you will get a compound like this. The hydrogens present in this aldehyde are replaced with chlorines. Then what do you get? CCl3CHO. Simple. The hydrogens present in this methyl group. The hydrogens present in the methyl group are replaced with chlorine. So you will get this compound which is known as trichloroacetaldehyde. Okay? Trichloroacetaldehyde. Simple. CH3CHO is what? Acetaldehyde. Isn't it? We are replacing the three hydrogens with the three chlorines. So it is trichloroacetaldehyde and HCl. Okay, Nana? HCl. So then let us balance this. So three chlorines and then three HCl, 3 plus 3, 6. Right? So acetaldehyde reacts with chlorine and forms trichloroacetaldehyde. Right? Trichloroacetaldehyde. And let me tell the common name of this. It is chlorol. What is it, Nana? Chlorol. 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 Please remember. Now let us see the next reaction here. So this is addition of PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride. So acetaldehyde reacts with phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride. PCl5. What does it form? See here. What does it form? You had to tell me the name of this. See, this is Cl. This is Cl. This is H. Yes. Many times I told you about this compound, such type of compound, isn't it? When the two halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon. When the two halogens are attached to the same carbon. Yes. It is a geminal dihalide, isn't it? What is it? Geminal dihalide. And the name of this is ethylidene chloride. Ethylidene chloride. Okay, Nana? So this is a geminal dihalide or gem dihalide. Okay, Nana? Right. Now, so these are the two properties. So one is addition of chlorine and HCl. That is chlorination, and chloral is the product obtained here, and this is addition of PCl5, and what is the product obtained here? Ethylidene chloride. 1 minute, I have written as chlorine. We'll rewrite it. This is ethylidene chloride. Okay, Nana? Ethylidene chloride. Yes. And what is this POCl3? Phosphoric chloride. Okay, I hope you are all copying these reactions, Nana. Try to understand us. Okay, so please try to cooperate with us after losing your time. So please don't repent. Oh, we have lost time. Why? Because we can earn money if we lose money, but never we will get the time back if we lose it. Okay, please don't do that. The next reaction is oxidation. Oxidation, addition of oxygens or removal of hydrogen, isn't it? So the first one is with the strong oxidizing agents. Okay, with the strong oxidizing agents. With strong oxidizing agents. Right? H plus. Means in acidic medium, KMnO4, potassium permanganate or nitric acid. See, these are all the strong oxidizing agents, right? Or with weak oxidizing agents. Now, let us see what happens. What does it give? Acetaldehyde, here I'm going to mention you many points, okay? So, I think I'm not... I'm going in detail only, children. So acetaldehyde on oxidation gives carboxylic acid. Yes. Acetic acid. What acid? Acetic acid. So we'll go for another color such that you can remember it well. This is acetaldehyde and this is acetic acid. That is ethanoic acid. Let me write the IUPAC name for this, children. This is ethanol, aldehyde. And this is ethanoic acid. How many carbons? 2 carbons, isn't it? And then a carboxylic acid. So ethanoic acid. So acetaldehyde on oxidation. See, here it may be a strong oxidizing agent or a weak oxidizing agent. Any oxidizing agent you may use, children, you will get the acetic acid. And now here I want to mention you few points, children. So please try to note down all this. So aldehydes on oxidation give carboxylic acids. On oxidation give carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids. Okay. Carboxylic acids with same number of carbon atoms that I want to mention you. With same number of carbon atoms. Same number of carbon atoms. Please remember. Right? Carbon atoms. Okay. So then, so this is the thing which I want to mention you children. Aldehydes on oxidation give carboxylic acids with same number of carbon. See here, two carbons, two carbon, finish. Okay. So then after that, another point what I want to tell you is on oxidation with weak oxidizing agents. I will write here. On oxidation with weak oxidizing agents, with weak oxidizing agents, weak oxidizing agents like bromine water, comma tollens reagent, ammonical silver nitrate is called as tollens reagent. I will go with the test also, but here as I'm mentioning about oxidation, isn't it? So I'm giving all the important concepts to you. So on oxidation with bromine water, so this is the first condition what I want to tell you. The second one is on oxidation with weak oxidizing agents like bromine water, tollens reagent, comma Fehling solution, okay, Skiff's reagent, Benedict's solution, aldehydes give carboxylic acids with same number of carbon atoms, with same number of carbon atoms. Please remember, carbon atoms. So these reagents are used to identify the aldehydes and ketones. Means I can say that all these reagents are used to distinguish aldehydes and ketones, to differentiate aldehydes and ketones. Okay. So I will write that last point here. So all these reagents are used to distinguish. All these reagents are used to distinguish aldehydes and ketones. Distinguish aldehydes from ketones. Okay, Nana? So please remember, Nana. So these are the very important tests, how to identify the aldehydes and ketones, because both of them are carbonyl compounds, isn't it? Yes. So oxidation with strong oxidizing agents, so it will give acetic acid. With weak oxidizing agents also it will give acetic acid. And here the important thing is both of them contain same number of carbon atoms. And then on oxidation with the weak oxidizing agents like bromine water, tollens reagent, Fehling solution, Skiff's reagent, Benedict solution, then aldehydes will give carboxylic acids with same number of carbon atoms. Okay, then all these reagents are used to distinguish the aldehydes from ketones. Okay, so now I think Shailja ma'am, can I take 5 more minutes, ma'am?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Please continue. Yeah.
Just 5 more minutes, ma'am, and I will wind up. Yes. So then the next one is oxidation. Oxidation with selenium dioxide, SCO2. Right? Now let us see this. Acetaldehyde, okay? Acetaldehyde on oxidation with selenium dioxide, SCO2. Now, what do you get? You will get this compound. What is this compound, children? This is glyoxal. Glyoxal. Okay, Nana? Glyoxal. Right? So, this alpha methylene group is oxidized to aldehyde group. Please remember, selenium dioxide oxidizes the alpha methylene group, alpha methylene group to methylene group to C double bond O group. That's why, see, already one aldehyde group is here, isn't it? And another aldehyde group is obtained. That is the meaning of this sentence. Please note down. Okay, so then, and then I will move to another point, what I want to mention you here. So I'll go for another color. Then this is oxidation with para-acids. Okay, para-acids. Now this is the name reaction again, you have to add in your page. So this is the Bayer-Villager oxidation. Okay, Nana? So oxidation with para-acids. So those who are preparing for competitive examinations, all these reactions will help you. Definitely they are going to help you, children. One day definitely you are going to remember me. So this is the aldehyde RCHO, right? So this on oxidation with para-acid, right? It gives again our carboxylic acid, RCOOH. Okay, Nana? Now, here you have to remember the para-acids will oxidize the aldehydes into carboxylic acid. Okay, Nana? So, this is about the aldehyde oxidation reactions, children. And now, in my next session, I will deal with the remaining name reactions of aldehydes and also the reactions of ketones. Okay. Thank you, Shailja ma'am.
Thank you, madam. You have elaborately covered all the reactions.
Thank you, ma'am.
The named reactions are very, very important. And thank you, madam, for the elaborative coverage. Children, please revisit these sessions, all the sessions, carbonyl compounds, particularly organic chemistry is very important, as we have been keeping on telling. So please practice, revisit, make your own notes. As I have told you earlier also, madam is giving elaborate explanation and all points she is covering in a extensive way. So please do make a note of all the things. Every word madam is uttering is very, very important. As madam said, you will be remembering her when you encounter such concepts in your competitive examinations. So please stay tuned. Please keep learning. Practice makes you more perfect. That is the only mantra for organic chemistry.
Yes, ma'am, definitely. They will get all such type of application questions in their JEE mains and also for the NEET examinations, ma'am. Just they have to learn the concept and they have to apply whatever the question which is given for them. Yes. So these are all the basics and basic concepts from carbonyl compounds. And see children, carbonyl compounds include many name reactions. And in my next session, I am going to deal with all those name reactions like Wolff-Kishner reduction, Clemmensen's reduction, aldol condensation, then crossed aldol condensation, then Cannizzaro's reaction. What happens if they do not contain alpha hydrogen atoms? And then if they contain alpha hydrogen atom, what type of reactions do they undergo? And about all the mechanisms, I'm going to teach you elaboratedly, right? So thank you, Shailja ma'am. Thank you for
Thank you, madam. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.